You make me climb those fucking stairs just to see you again, and my first order of business will be tossing you and that poxy chair into the fucking ocean.
Philip, do you know the provenance of the chair in which I currently sit?
What?
This chair once sat in the Plymouth office of one Sir Francis Drake. I took this chair from a prize off the coast of Boston. I lost 6 men in that fight. Now, ever since then, this chair has resided here atop my fort from which I survey the harbor that I protect for the good of an ungrateful island. Philip, if Mr. Gates should ever lay a hand on my chair, you have my permission to shoot him where he stands.
Yes, sir, Captain Hornigold.
How are you, Ben? Don't be pleasant with me. I know why you're here. The Lurker de Lima. Every captain on the island's buzzing about who'll be joining you in consort.
News travels fast.
Time was the thought of taking on a treasure galleon would have gotten you laughed off a crew.
The world's changed, Ben. Some risks nowadays, it's more dangerous not to take them.
Jesus, now you're talking like him. Bro, I'm to be Flint's new consort, huh? Is that what it is? He couldn't come down here and ask me himself.
He thinks you don't like him.
Then he's right. The man's arrogant and presumptuous.
Be that as it may, he doesn't want you as the consort.
And what does he want?
Your ship and your crew. The offer is 1 share per man, 2 for you personally, in exchange for your support in persuading the men to vote in favor.
And who exactly is going to captain my ship under these arrangements? Oh, you!
Oh, don't say it like that. It's not such a crazy idea.
Isn't it?
Well, look, he doesn't want somebody new. He and I share a kind of a shorthand. Your ship is sound. Your crew know and trust me. It makes the most sense.
You assume too much. I'm not even certain my men trust me at this stage.
Any news from your friends in Edinburgh?
The last I heard, James fled to France. I call him the Pretender now. I promised my men that if they stayed with me, they'd be soldiers again. That they'd be part of a rebel navy, fighting a war to restore a rightful king. Now...
Well, they'd never desert you.
Who knows what they'll do? They're coming to terms with a very uncomfortable truth.
And what is that?
No matter how many lies we tell ourselves, or no matter how many stories we convince ourselves we're part of, we're all just thieves awaiting a noose.
And what do I tell Flint?
That after 50 years at sea, you're the only man I've ever met that's gotten dumber with age.